Hello friends, now we see the problem number 6, which is also based on first principle of derivative of chapter differentiation. The problem number 6 is f of x is equal to x into sec x. And by using first principle of derivative, we have to find f dash x. So now let's see the solution. First of all, f of x is equal to x into sec x. Therefore, the next step is f of x plus h. It means whenever x, we have to write x plus h. So that equal to x plus h into sec in bracket x plus h. Then by using first principle of derivative, we have f dash x is equal to limit h tend to 0 f of x plus h minus f x upon h. Now that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now for f of x plus h, we substitute x plus h into sec x plus h, and minus for fx we substitute x into sec x and then totally divide by h. So that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now here we open the bracket, so we get x into sec of x plus h plus h into sec of x plus h, and finally minus x into sec x, and then we have whole thing divided by h. So that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now from first term and last term we take x common, so x in bracket we have sec of x plus h minus sec x bracket complete, and then the second term that h into sec of x plus h we write as it is, and then whole thing divided by h. Now here x is a constant as limit totally depend on h, so we take outside the limit, so it is x times limit h tends to 0 sec of x plus h minus sec x upon h as a one limit, and then plus limit h tends to 0 h into sec of x plus h totally divided by h. That equal to x into limit h tends to 0. Now here sec theta means 1 upon cos theta. So we have here 1 upon cos of x plus h minus 1 upon cos x, and then whole thing divided by h. Plus in the second bracket we cancel h from numerator and denominator and substitute value h as 10 to 0. So we get sec of x plus 0. Stating the result that since h tends to 0 and therefore h not equal to 0. So it means we cancel h from numerator and denominator in the second limit. Is equal to now x into, in the first limit we have limit h tends to 0, and on cross multiplying we get cos x minus cos of x plus h whole thing divided by cos of x plus h into cos x into h, and the bracket complete. Plus, we left with the term that sec x. So, is equal to x into limit h tends to 0. Now, in the numerator, we again apply same formula, that cos c minus cos d. So, by using that formula, we have minus 2 in bracket sine bracket x plus x plus h upon 2 into sine in bracket x minus h upon 2, and then totally divide by cos of x plus h into cos x into h. The bracket complete plus sec x. So that equal to x into limit h tends to 0. Now here the term that minus 2 is a number which is a constant, we take outside the limit. So it is minus 2x outside the limit. And then in the limit we have sine in bracket x plus x gives 2x plus h upon 2 as a one limit into limit h tends to 0. Now in the second bracket plus x minus x we cancel. So we left with sine of minus h by 2, and in the denominator also we have h, so that we write minus h by 2, and to adjust the limit we have to multiply by minus 1 by 2, and then whole thing divided by cos of x plus h into cos x, and plus the remaining term that sec x we write as it is. So that equal to minus 2x into sine in bracket 2x for h we write 0 as a limit upon 2 into limit h tends to 0 sine of minus h by 2 upon minus h by 2, that gives 1 into minus 1 by 2 whole thing divided by cos in bracket x plus 0 into cos x plus the remaining term that sec x. So on simplifying further, here we cancel minus 2 from numerator denominator and also 2 from numerator denominator inside the sine function. So we left with x into sine x upon cos x into cos x plus sec x. So the next step will be is equal to, we write x as it is, into, we write 1 upon cos x, into, we write sin x upon cos x, and plus the remaining term that sec x we write as it is. So x into, now 1 upon cos gives sec x into sin x upon cos x tan x, and plus sec x. So in this way we get f dash x is equal to x into sec x into tan x plus sec x. So this is a required solution for the given problem. Thank you.